field goal allocates 4.5% of budget to health in 12 years. Field goal, states allocated 6% of budget to health in 2019. Malaria claims 73,680 Nigerians in 4 months. Nigeria loses 216,000 children, 22,310 pregnant women this year. If the federal government and state governments had not been paying lip service to healthcare funding, Nigeria would have been at a vantage position to combat the prevailing COVID-19 pandemic sweeping across the world. In the last 12 years, the federal government allocated N3.346 trillion, 4.48%, of its N74.70 trillion budgets to health. In 2019, the federal government, 36 state governments and the federal capital territory, Abuja allocated N1.119 trillion, 6.17%, of their collective N18.134 trillion budgets to health. These are far cries from the World Health Organization, WHO's recommendation of 13% or the Abuja 2001 declaration by the African Union of 15%. Medical facilities at the federal level would have been better if the federal government had spent N11.21 trillion, 15% of N74.70 trillion, on healthcare in the last 12 years. Matters are made worse by incomplete release of the budgetary funds, and the bulk of funds released go for recurrent expenditure, salaries and emoluments, instead of capital projects. Aisha Buhari's lamentation. In October 2017, First Lady Aisha Buhari re-echoed lamentations of healthcare givers and stakeholders over the poor state of affairs in the sector. She publicly upbraided the chief medical director of the State House Medical Center, Dr. Hussein Munir, for the poor state of the health facility established to take care of the president, vice president, their families, as well as members of staff of the presidential villa, Abuja. Then her husband, President Muhammadu Buhari, had been abroad for medication for about 6 months. Speaking at the opening of a two-day stakeholders meeting on reproductive, maternal, newborn child, adolescent health and nutrition held at the banquet hall of the presidential villa, she said, "If somebody like Mr. President can spend several months outside Nigeria, then you wonder what will happen to him on in the street. Few weeks ago, I was sick as well. They advised me to take the first flight out to London. I refused to go. I said I must be treated in Nigeria because there is a budget for an assigned clinic to take care of us. If the budget is N100M, we need to know how the budget is spent. Along the line, I insisted they call Aso Clinic to find out if the X-ray machine is working. They said it was not working. They didn't know I was the one that was supposed to be in that hospital at that very time. I had to go to a hospital that was established by foreigners 100%. What does that mean? So, I think it is high time we did the right thing. If something like this can happen to me, there is no need for me to ask the governor's wives what is happening in their states. This is Abuja and this is the highest seat of government, and this is the presidential villa." More than 2 years after the First Lady's lamentations, little or nothing was done to improve on the sector. The federal and state governments' budgetary allocations to health remained miserly, while Nigeria's health indices continued to rend the heart. Poor health indices. Currently, Nigeria accounts for 20-23% of global deaths from maternal mortality, women who die due to complications from pregnancy or childbirth. The World Health Organization puts the figure at 20%, while the lead consultant of the National Safety Data, MSD, Mary Anne Tibet, said it is 23%. This means that of the 97,000 women who died from pregnancy and childbirth complication between January and April 23, 2020, according to WorldMed,